Hello everyone and welcome back to another exciting PowerPoint animation tutorial. And this time we are going to make this responsive frog animation using action settings and a few animation effects. This animation is a replica of Dario Corsi's works at codepen.io. He used HTML, CSS, and JavaScript and we are using just PowerPoint to replicate the same. We used a total of 33 slides, and you can even use more or fewer slides depending on how many movements you want to apply. We have created 6 types of movement through these 33 slides like left, right, up, down, diagonal up right, and diagonal up left. Once you understand the concept of using action settings, then you can add more directions to your characters. You can also draw any other character instead of a frog to showcase different poses of the character on each slide and then use action setting to add movements according to the mouse movement. You can also watch our tutorial on how to make a responsive piano using action settings where we used wave sound files. The link to that video is given in the description and in the cards. It might look difficult to make this kind of animation by using so many slides, but I assure you that you will be able to grasp the idea in 2 minutes after watching the complete tutorial. So, let's first talk about why we are using so many slides. If we move forward through these slides from the thumbnail view, then you can see that each slide represents a different pose of the frog. On each slide, we moved the frog's legs, hands, body, head, eyes, and support into different directions. Again, if we move over to the first slide and open the animation pane, then you can see that a total of 6 animation effects has been used. We used only the grow, shrink effect on different body parts of the frog. Let's first talk about the frog's eyes. To create the eye blinking effect, we used the grow, shrink effect with a 2% vertical ratio with auto reverse. Time duration is 0.25 seconds with a delay timing of 2 seconds. We used the same effect on all 4 layers to create the inner and outer parts of the eyes. Now, if we look for the mouth and body, then you can see that we again used the grow, shrink effect with 80% and 90% vertical ratio with auto reverse and time duration of 0.75 seconds. Once you have your first slide ready, then it's time to replicate the same slide, change the direction of body parts, and then finally apply the action settings. From the thumbnail view, select the first slide and then press Ctrl plus D to make a duplicate. On the second slide, change the direction of the body parts. You can either do that manually or open the Format Shape pane and click the Size and Properties tab. From the Size and Properties window, you can rotate the shapes to a specific degree. Again, if I move through slides and select the frog's legs, then you can see the different rotation and positions that we applied, and we did the same for the rest of the body parts of the frog on different slides. It's then time to apply the action settings, and if I move to the first slide and press the Ctrl plus a key to select all the objects, then you will notice that many of the objects have been selected which are not visible on the slide otherwise. If you open the selection pane, then you can notice that we have drawn a lot of oval shapes, which are not visible on any of the slides by default. If I select all these ovals and then unselect the frog's body parts and apply the fill color, then you will be able to see all those shapes. Finally, we apply an action setting to each of the ovals that when you will hover your mouse over any of these ovals, then it will take you to a specific slide, where we have moved the frog to a different direction. For instance, if I select one of these oval and go to the Insert tab and then click Action, then you can see that we have applied a mouse over action setting, which is hyperlinked to slide number 15. If you move to slide 15, then you can see that we have moved the frog's body parts in a different direction. So, we applied the same action settings to each of the ovals and each one of them represent a different slide in the presentation. After applying the action setting and hiding all these ovals using no fill and no outline, we later copied all these ovals on all the slides to make a loop. Once you are done with all this, see the preview and start hovering your mouse over those hidden ovals, and the slideshow will start jumping to those slides hyperlinked through action settings. That is what it all takes to add life to your characters and make them responsive in PowerPoint. I hope you will like the idea and the tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. Subscribe to our channel, The Teacher, for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks a lot for watching this video till the end, and take good care of yourself.